of the belief that I am entitled. I'm entitled to a laptop. I'm entitled to a cell phone. But the bride of Christ is one with the fullness of Christ. And the bride will come from a portion of the body of Christ rather than being the entire body. Genesis chapter 2:22. Remember, where was Eve taken? From the side of Adam. Not the whole body of Adam. So, if the body of Christ is the church, the bride will only come from a portion of the body, but not from the whole body itself, because much of the body is not bridal. Just look at the kind of Christianity that we have today, the music that we listen to, the clothes that we wear, the language that we speak. Ano ba kita? Do we sound like we are the bride? Oh, we are members of the church. For are you bride? No. The bride will have a sincere and pure devotion to Christ. And bride is watchful and prayerful. So watchful and prayerful. No? The bride is pressing for perfection. Because a bride, conscious of the wedding, perfect ang everything. So ang bride may ara nga drive to be so much better than what she was before. That is the bride. And the bride is anointed by the Holy Spirit. But the bride lives in a state of readiness and eagerness to meet the bridegroom. You know a person, a Christian, if bridal siya, because of joy and laughter. The bride loves to be in the presence of the groom. A bride loves to sing in the presence of the groom. The point here is this. You are the same person, but you have a different mindset, appearance, behavior, action, priority, focus, if you move from just being a woman or girlfriend to now about to be married, fiancé or bride. There is a transformation, a change, a radiance, a glory found in the bride, not found in the ordinary woman. Okay, look at this for example. This is my church. Okay, okay, this is my church. Kilala nyo ng church? Huh? Okay. But this is the bride. Okay. So, this is the church. Okay. But this church cannot come to a wedding in that attire. Cannot be. Correct? If in the last days there is a wedding, the church has to be this. Because you are attending a wedding. What you see here is not physical ang ginaistorya natin. In the spiritual life natin, they are the same person, but the end times call for the wedding of the man and his bride. And he is not picking up the unprepared, unattired, unadorned fiancé. He is picking up the ready bride. And I will have to tell you, even if it will shock you, when the groom comes and he finds his church not in bridal posture, he will leave some of them behind to go through the tribulation period. Okay, I know that you have not been taught that way. He is picking up the ready bride. Even as the wedding will not proceed if our girlfriend is not ready, the bride has to be prepared. Okay, now, I want you to prepare yourself for the next picture. The Lord speaks to us in pictures, but please reflect upon this picture for a few moments when you see it. It is a very sad picture of a very pitiful bride. And I just want us to reflect. Is this a picture of us? Amuning spiritual condition ta? Is this the picture of the church? Please reflect on this next picture for a few moments. If Jesus Christ comes today for the church, will we find a church in this condition? Bound, soiled, ashamed to meet the groom. I feel a great sadness in my heart that a huge segment of the church is in this condition. Because this is how we really just stand before the Lord. We are not ready. We are His girlfriend, yes. He died for us, yes. But we have not been ready for the wedding. This is our situation. Now, this is what God wants to do with us. Siling sa Ephesians chapter 5 verse 25 to 27. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for us. Ginhimo ko ni personal. That he might sanctify and cleanse us with the washing of water to the word. That he might present us to himself a glorious church, a glorious bride, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that we should be holy and blameless. So amuning gustuhin mo unsang aton nga crown prince sa aton. So from this, very sad. In fact, tonight, before we say goodbye to this place, I really pray that if there is anybody here among us tonight, who in your spirit now has a witness, Lord, oh gosh, I think I look that way to you. I hope and pray that this is what will happen to us. Where we will be washed with water through the word. Okay, second issue. Galatians chapter 3 verse 28 says, there is neither Jew nor Greek, slave nor free, male nor female, for you are all one in Christ. Meaning sang one, hindi nga one in number, but same. Meaning whether laki or bayi, we are all the same in Christ. He created us in His image. Eve was the external manifestation of the feminine part in Adam. So whether we are male or female, we are the external manifestation of God's image and are able to seek a relationship with God as Eve did with Adam and vice versa. Very interesting in fact. Ang ngalan sa Hebrew nga Yahweh is a combination of two Hebrew words, Yud and I. No? The name for Adam is Ash, which is spelled using the Hebrew letters Aleph, Yud, Shin. Munang letter sa Hebrew. Ang Eve nga ngalan is Elisha in Hebrew, which is spelled Aleph, Shin, I. Ang inang I, ara na siya sa God. Ang Yud, ara na siya sa God. Ang ngalan sang laki, ara sa God. Ang bayi, ara sa God. So the Yud in Adam's name is the male characteristic of God not found in Eve's name. And Hi in Eve's name is the female characteristic of God not found in Adam's name. Therefore, whether you are male or female, you can have a relationship with Christ in the sense of intimacy because we are all one in Christ. The one in Christ or ace is neuter without regard to gender. Okay, example of men in the Bible, macho gining mga lalaki, pero bridal ang ilang quality. Please take note what Paul said. Do you not know that he who unites himself with a prostitute is one with her in body? For it is said that two will become one flesh. But he who unites himself with the Lord is one with him in spirit. Ang word na nga unite is the same word in Hebrew as cleave. A man shall leave his father and mother and unite with his wife, cleave with his wife. So a marital paradigm is suggested here. David is the only person in the Bible described with these words. He is a man after my heart or after God's own heart. Can you imagine, hindi bayi ang gindescriban nga after God's own heart. Of course, Mary, the mother of Jesus, was called highly favored. Blessed are you amongst women. But is no person in the Bible called a man after God's own heart. Let us not look at Jesus in a sexual way so that we will not have a difficulty accepting ourselves as bridal, as bride. Okay? So he was a man after God's own heart. Grabe gidya ang bridal intimacy ni David. Look at this. In Psalm 27 verse 4, he wants to spend his time in the temple to gaze at the beauty of the Lord. This is bridal quality. To gaze at the beauty of the Lord. Bridal ni. Oh, ari pagido, si David ni. As the deer panted for the water, so my soul longeth after thee. John the Beloved, lean on Jesus' breast. This is a bridal quality that John the Beloved showed. In fact, it is this quality that enable John to know who is the betrayer. I-check up nyo lang sa inyo Bible, Luke chapter 13 verses 21 to 28, in relation with these other passages. Of all the 12 disciples, only John knew that Judas Iscariot was the traitor, because he was closest to the heart of Jesus. In these last days, only the bridal Christian will know the betrayer around him, because intimacy with Jesus will tell him, halong na, seducer na, traitor na, betrayer na. You cannot come to that conclusion if you do not have bridal intimacy with Jesus. Okay. So being male is not an issue. All it takes is a heart devoted to know and love Him. Sa Song of Songs, chapter 6, verse 3, I am my beloved's and my beloved is mine. Okay, alipagid. Si John the Baptist, these are examples of men who clearly understood Jesus as groom. Silingaw, you yourselves can testify that I said, I am not the Christ, but I'm sent ahead of Him. The bride belongs to the bridegroom. The friend who attends the bridegroom waits and listens for him, and is full of joy when he hears the bridegroom's voice. That joy is mine and is now complete. He must become great, I must become less. He must increase while I must decrease. Si John the Baptist considered himself as the best man of the groom. I am just amazed that John the Baptist understood his ministry as friend of the bridegroom. Remember, it never entered my mind that I am the best man of the groom and I'm supposed to help prepare the bride. Oh, siling ni Paul, I am jealous for you with a godly jealousy. I promise you to one husband to Christ so that I might present you as a pure virgin to Him. Any threat to your purity, to your sanctity, to your sanctification, to your nearness, gaka-alarm si Paul. Remember, God created man in His image and likeness. Pero look at this, 1 Corinthians chapter 11, because it is now Paul explaining what creation meant. Siling ni Paul, man is the image and glory of God, while woman is the glory of man. Please take note that woman is not the image of man. Husbands, do not make your wife in your own image. Okay? The wife is still the image of God, but the wife is the glory of the man, and the man is the glory of God. Now, let us look at this word glory. You will be amazed at what this means. Okay. This is the word glory in Hebrew. Glory either means adereth, which means adornment, hod, meaning beauty, splendor, or majesty, yekar, meaning precious, rare, or special, kabod, meaning weighty or authoritative, chebi, meaning beautiful or desirable, kleios, meaning celebrant or celebrity. Amuling meaning sa word na glory, 6 of the 12 names in Hebrew mentioned. Meaning, if the Bible says, husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave Himself up for her, that He might present her to Himself as a glorious church, God wants to give man adornment, beauty, majesty, preciousness, rarity, specialness, weight, authority, beauty, desirability, celebrity. When God wants to give you glory, and Ephesians 5 says He wants you to present, to be presented to Himself as a glorious bride, this is what He wants you to have, wants you and me to have. Look at the bridal principle in creation, Genesis 1. In the beginning, God has already prepared a place for His bride. 5 days of prior creation before man was created on the 6th day. Ang groom, in the Hebrew context, prepares a place for His bride. John chapter 14 is a groom statement to the bride. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. The word prepare a place for you is the statement of the groom for a bride. In the garden, God walked and talked with man. Ang walking and talking in the second session is a bridal characteristic, because the bride and the groom loves to take walks together. There is a problem in a relationship when the husband and wife do not want to walk together anymore. God